Whenever I call, you are there. Whenever I pray, Lord, you hear me. I'm not alone, this I know. What can I bring to you, Lord, but the song of praise, long and at
through Christ our Lord, your Son, the first book of Samuel. Samuel was lying in the sanctuary of the Lord, where the ark of God was, when the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel," he answered, "Here I am." Then he ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, since you called me." Eli said, "I did not call. Go back and lie down." So he went and lay down. Once again, the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am." He replied, "I did not call you, my son. Go back and lie down." Samuel had as yet no knowledge of the Lord, and the word of the Lord has not yet been revealed to him. Once again, the Lord called, the third time. He got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, since you called me." The Lord, who was calling the boy, and he said to Samuel, "Go and lie down, and if someone calls, say, 'Speak, Lord, your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. The Lord then came and stood by, calling as he had done before, "Samuel, Samuel." And Samuel answered, "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, and let no word of his fall to the ground. The word of the Lord.
The response is, "Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will."
Here I am, Lord. From the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. The body is not meant for fornication, it is for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. God who raised the Lord from the dead will by his power raise us up too. You know surely that your bodies are members making up the body of Christ. Anyone who is joined to the Lord is one spirit with him. Keep away from fornication. All the other sins are committed outside the body. But to fornicate, to sin against your own body, is a temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, since you received him from God. You are not your own property. You have been bought and paid for. That is why you should use your body for the glory of God.
Of the Lord.
May we rise.
Stood with two of his disciples, Jesus passed, and John stared hard at him and said, "Look, there is the Lamb of God." Hearing this, the two disciples followed Jesus. Jesus turned round, saw them following him, and said, "What do you want, Miss Peter? Where do you live?" "Come and see," he replied. So they went and saw where he lived and stayed with him the rest of that day. It was about the 10th hour. One of these two, who became followers of Jesus, after hearing what John had said, was Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, his brother, and said to him, "We have found the Messiah," which means the Christ. And he took Simon to Jesus. Jesus looked hard at him and said, "You are Simon, son of John. You are to be called Cephas," meaning rock. The Gospel of the Lord.
He's not moving front and back. Nobody here wants to See the prayers that come from the heart. And tell myself, woman, carry your drunkenness from the house of God. Go outside, see somewhere, and be displaying your alcohol and the prostitute. What was Hannah's response to this accusation? I have given no drop has crossed my mouth, but the bitterness of my heart, the pains of my heart, I receive from the insults of those who don't mind their business and insulting me that I am barren, that I have no child. That is what I will find to my God. And then I said, okay, if you have cried out the pains of your heart, bad market, bad business, your children are stubborn, your husband does not come in, your wife is not doing anything, all those who are there, what you are pouring out to God, let God listen to your prayers and fulfill your heart desires. Did it come true? Yes. My brothers and sisters, you go to the wrong places. You go to the wrong places. Number one. Number three. God, if you are able to clean this shame and tears from my eyes, the first one you give me, I will offer it to God. And the first one happened to be Samuel. So the altar to God, Elijah, to my name, to Eli, take Samuel. Let me serve you in the altar. Let me not go home. The child, look after the mother, was obedient, was always in the church, working day and night. If you make a promise to God, big or small, what you do to fulfill it or score, make sure you fulfill it. Number three, because Samuel was a faithful child, many of the children are not faithful. Their mother is going left, they are going right. Their mother is going forward, they are back. Their mother knows the church, the child don't know the church. If you go to the church, it's searching for gold to pick, searching for something to pick from the portals. They are imminent God. You can see your father and your mother. These are imminent God. You can see. Listen to them. Unless they ask you to commit sin, refuse. Come out for your own holiness. While Samuel was resting, because he had been tired of the work he did that day, he was resting, half asleep, half awake. God came. Samuel, Samuel. Young Samuel, he has a physical mentor. Somebody is working under, and that is Eli, the high priest. So to whom did Samuel run to? Eli. Here I am for you, call me. No, my son, I didn't. He went. Even before sleep could come, Samuel, Samuel, God has a message for your God delivered it. Samuel again went to the master. How many of us respect our master? How many of us respect our parents? That old car. Come here, go away, your car is not passed. No, these are time. It's not that type of thing you are talking about. That's an idol and fresh water. Come here. A wife said, a husband, wife is not for marriage course. Come here. You mean that I have been cooking in the house? Because that was the topic that day, that the wife has to provide for the family, they put food for the husband and for the household. He said, that is, you hear what I say? He said, yes, I've heard it. What does he say? That I, after all my university, after all my school, is now going to the kitchen and cook. Said, yes, you are my wife. Oh, you are still saying yes? Okay, bye-bye. I cannot subject all my personality, a big girl like me, go to the kitchen to cook. If you don't get somebody who will cook for us, then forget about it. And the way the marriage ended there, don't know when to put salt at the beginning of cooking or pepper at the last. Don't know when to put oil and when to put mangi. He does not know. I last again. You refuse to take training from your parents. The first person is by giving half head to do all the housework and you are playing for food again and you are there running around the house, then we do not bring you to near cooking or else you will be stressed. This baby, this wonderful boy, let him not do any work. You spoil your child. You have to learn from your parents to be close to house girl so that you know what to do. Samuel is responsible, went to the master the second time, and the master said, I didn't call you, go and rest. And the third call came, if it is children of this year, I'm not going to anywhere. Every time I didn't call you. Every time I didn't call you. This time I'm not going to anywhere. Let me think will happen. Make it happen. Make me stay. The Samuel says so. See humility. See patience. These are the qualities of that day that will win you God's favor in 2015. Trust. Samuel went back to the letter and returned the issue. Eli returned the time and he said, my son, I did not call you. For this man, as an elderly person, did not remember. It could be God calling this young man. I know, of course, he has a message. So, my son, as you go back, he began the calls again, saying, speak, Lord. Who is listening? You are servant. So, Lord, you like to speak, you don't like to give up. I don't care for this type of sound.
Actually, I don't answer before, I come now.
Samuel, the fourth time, not one, not two, the fourth time, was not anxious, was not excited, was not annoyed. Speak, Lord, your servant is listening. God is calling each and every one of you, each and every one of us, in this 2015, he's calling your name, by name, by name. It remains for me to say, here I am, Lord. I, your servant, am listening. He's calling your name, Peter. He's calling your name, Caroline. He's calling your name, Ugobi. He's calling your name, Chubike. He's calling your name, Tamunu. He's calling your name. Okay. If you listen to God, he's going to deliver a message to you. But if you are arrogant and proud, and think that because you are what you are,